Hello and welcome to Adventures in Watercolor. Today we'll be taking a look at drawing an LDS temple using rendering of watercolor behind it. And this will be about a 15 minute, and we'll show you a little bit of our sketch style for use in our class. The materials I'm going to be using today are part of your materials list. I have my watercolors, the small set. Trusty watercolor brush, one for picking up water and one to paint with. Also have a mechanical pencil, or you could use any pencil, and just in case, a ruler. This work is going to be done in your sketchbook. The size is about a postcard size, about 5 by 7. We're going to make a frame, and I'm going to try and get in early with this image of the Grand Junction temple that I visited in September. Focus in on it in September, and we want to at least be among the first persons to do this temple, so that we can gain a little bit of notoriety and also promote our style of artwork. So let's get going. And let me not be remiss, there's two more pieces here. Of course, the water to dip the brush for our watercolor. And I picked up a new package of sponges from Michael's. These ones are about $4. Comes in a couple different kinds. And I prefer some of these natural ones, the smaller ones, just in case you want to come back and wet the sky or do things like that. I'm going to attempt using my cell phone that I recorded the pictures on to produce this postcard sketch. And let's get going. I'm going to use a graphite pencil and to begin the process. Okay, I'm going to create the horizon line. I want this to be a loose sketch, so but for the horizon line, I'll go ahead and use my straight edge to kind of mimic where I want the building itself to go. Okay, we're going to go with a loose style. I'll bring this a little bit closer, take a look at it, and I'm going to locate remember the rule of thirds, or maybe not. We're going to put the tower part more or less a little bit off center. And I like to just start with geometry that I'm going to work with. Building with the cube is always helpful. This is perfect for it. This one, the cube. Yeah, we're just going to let the hand be shaky if it wants. That's going to be considered more of a loose sketch. And getting the main features outlined. Let's see, and unfortunately I'm kind of cut off, so let's see if I have more in there. So I do. So I'm gonna, it's like there's three tiers, 1, 2, 3, and then keep adding. I'm gonna start with this archway as the main focus, and now I can start going in there with a more loose line. And almost how we did the gestural drawings, we're just kind of loose, kind of don't take your pencil off the target, to just kind of keep it on the paper. Archway again, it looks like it's mimicked. Looks like this continues, and they've got very nice strong edges on the end. I did include a little link to the website, the construction website for this. It gives a little bit more information about how the process is going. And one of our local employers here is the LDS Temple Churches. Looks there. So this is in Colorado, as I said. And now I'm just starting to go into some of the main shapes. The nice thing I have here is the line that kind of gives me a good guideline. So let's add that. So I'm looking for distinctive features. And it looks like it steps down. Looks like I have a little too much here. There's a little fudge there. Okay, so doorway. This little perspective is coming in. So it behooves me to add a little bit of perspective. I would break down here and show you the perspective lines running, but as a sketch, we're just going to go for it. This lamp would make a good detail. So we're going to include the lamp, and we see the ramp, and you start to fill out the, try and reach all parts of the postcard, at least loosely. Go a great way of helping, and it's sitting on a hill. We'll go look further than that. So let's get back into our details. Make sure that that line comes, and you can use any temple. Doesn't have to be this one, but we can also, the nice thing about learning all these different styles is you can see the arch, and you can see that 45-degree angle. Maybe it was the right time of day that I was there. Let's get these in. They're hiding behind that berm. So with this, the archway, those guys. The more you draw a specific building type, the more you know what to expect. So this one looks like it's the repeating archways are prominent. Okay. Now I can start to embellish things. Looking back, I can see that those are reliefs, not really windows. And now I'm starting to punch out specials. Let's check on our time. Okay. Trying to be fast and loose. So I did look the other pictures I had of the construction site. These are starting to pop out, the gateway. Let's use that as a focal point. So maybe that's really what we want to make this focal point. And this could be a little bit bigger than what's shown, because remember, part of the trick to rendering is to make a place alluring, and to create interest. So we're gonna maybe not reality, but we have a good pleasing composition, gateway entering, and it'll give us a chance to do a little of our hatchwork. And then just indications of where things might be. Brickwork, stonework is always good. So this is where you use your memory of the material symbols. It'll help you out. Okay, I'm jumping ahead a little bit so that we can make this within the 15-minute time frame and have some time to get into the watercolor. Because we've been sketching for a few weeks now, so maybe we're loosened up and we can start to. We can also go outside the bounds of this, because I might theoretically cut the card or crop it in a digital photograph, but kind of want to go fast. And it's okay to go over in the sketch mode. It really builds interest, right? Because you have these double lines going, and remember that our bold lines are reserved for things that are coming out at us, and a deeper look into our picture when needed will give us other clues to what's happening. And that window, very unique window up there. Okay, and I see that a triangle popping, I'm sorry, a square popping out that's significant. So I'm looking for significant pieces. I'm going to do a double line in here. Come down. And then let's see where the. Don't have the lamp on this picture. Now that you've had a chance to work with the elevation in the flat wash style, and you've seen some of Ben's work, you probably have more of a handle on some of the quick sketching in the background that's not well defined. These are the mountains, the book cliffs that are out there in Grand Junction. And now we can apply techniques of the watercolor that are, we can use the wash as one of them, but we're going to do more of a fast gestural watercolor. And this is the stuff that we were fighting against making when we made a wash, but now it's going to be our friend. So I'll lay down my final pencils, sketches, and we'll begin our watercolor. What I learned from the tapping down of the flat elevations washes is that we can use, since this is our image, we have a little practice area, right? And we're going to make use of that space. So I do get that nice Colorado sky. Let's get our blue and mix up a good little a wash that we've learned how to do for flat rendering. And let's make use of the wash. I'm going to elevate my drawing. Making use of that about a 30-degree angle to help the water flow. This is not watercolor paper, so here we go. So we're going to go ahead and it's your sketchbook paper. So it's going to have not quite the quality of the watercolor, but good enough for our purposes. So we're making our wash. Get a little dry there. Reinvigorate. Let's keep going. So I'm not shooting for the wash like I did during my elevation drawing. This is where your mistakes come in, because the mistakes you make on this actually turn out to be of a benefit to you. Got a wash in there. Nice Colorado blue sky, and we'll darken in as it reaches the edge there. And you can see that the mistakes actually are making some nice highlights for us. So you can add a little bit more water in there, make things stand out. And now we get to go to the landscape. Okay, next comes the book cliffs. And I'm gonna put in some color, and then I'm going to take off color with the my trusty tissue. Here are those shapes that you've learned how to draw thus far. We'll come back in with some tissue and pick up so that we don't have wet blobs. It's looking good. All right, so we're gonna keep going. Now we haven't had our color theory yet, and that's coming up, but we do want to be able to mix a green from this harder green, add yellow to it, get that springtime color, and then dapple that to some of these areas. It's always good to have like a dark and a light. And the now we're going to work with our dark. Let's show that. It's our palette. So we're mixing in here. This one might be more direct. So let's add the darkers in. That gives it some, and I'm not completely filling in, I'm not coloring in. It's not a coloring book, it's a sketch, architectural sketch. So that looks good. I'll dapple it, and then we can do a flat wash for the overall grass. Okay, so I'm adding in, because the building's white, all the shade and shadow is going to stand out. I have my dauber papers here so I can kind of make sure that I have more of a pure shadow. So let's ultramarine. Let's going to work some of that into it. I'm gonna leave the white. It looks like that pinnacle might actually be teal. So maybe we're going to come back in and work with our teal to complete this. And get some respectable grays in there. I'm just about done. Video, I'll show you my complete process, the completed one.